Hi there, Philips Hue have just made one of the biggest changes ever to the Hue app. Previously, you could access dozens of dynamic lighting effects by going into the Hue Labs section and configuring all your dynamic lighting effects there. But Philips Hue have recently announced that Hue Labs is closing down for good. Thankfully though, according to them, they've reassured people that you can recreate pretty much everything you want within the main Hue app instead. Is this true? Well, I hope so, because I've mentioned quite a few times on this channel about how I really dislike that the Hue app is split into two bits. The overly simple Hue app, and then the powerful but buggy Hue Labs area. Let's see if Hue has finally improved on this. The Hue blog discusses these changes in more detail, and even includes a chart of exactly how you can achieve the same functionality in the main Hue app, and I'll link to these down in the description. Let's go through some of these and see whether the chart is correct or not. So, one of the most popular effects from Hue Labs was ColorLoop, where you could set your RGB lights to cycle through a range of colours. When creating the lab formula, you could specify how quickly the colours should change, exactly what colours it should cycle through, and how you can activate this formula. In other words, you could manually trigger it from the app, or you could use a Hue accessory like the dimmer switch. But Philips Hue now says that you should be able to replace this dynamic formula with the Prism effect, so let's take a look at that. You should go into a light that sports full colour, in other words a white and colour ambience bulb or light strip, and then click the little icon that has three stars on it. There's then a Prism option. Press that and you have loads of configuration options. Kidding. It just starts cycling through the colours on the light. And that is pretty cool because it's much easier to configure that than the previous Hue Labs implementation. But there's no way of changing the speed of this effect, and as a result I kind of find this a bit too fast sometimes. Luckily there is some sort of workaround here, and I'll discuss that a bit later on. But can you trigger this effect through a Hue accessory? So if I go into the dimmer switch config section and I select a room that only has RGB lights in it, I then will start looking around for a way of setting the Prism effect here. And unfortunately, there's nothing obvious here, to be honest. If I try to add a scene, then there is a natural light option, which is good, but I can't see Prism listed anywhere here. In short, you can replace the basic color loop functionality within the Hue app, but you then lose speed control and you can't trigger it from a Hue accessory anymore. Philips Hue does say though that they're working on adding more functionality all the time, so if we believe them, then maybe they'll improve this area soon. The app also has candle and fireplace effects, and these are pretty neat actually. You can use the candle effect with white ambience bulbs too, so you don't need to go out and pay for the full colour options. Although fireplace does require full RGB. Either way though, they have the same limitations as the Prism effect. You can't currently change the speed or trigger them from the Hue dimmer switch anymore, for example. Now let's look at the dynamic scenes, because this is where things get a lot more powerful, sort of. There are a large number of built-in Hue scenes, which Hue's handy chart actually makes reference to a lot. If you wanted to replicate the Christmas Living Scenes effect, for example, you might want to click on the Hue Scenes gallery, scroll down to Winter Beauty, for example, and then press Save to My Scenes, and not Set Once. This is important. Once it's actually saved to your scenes, you can then play this effect as a dynamic effect, whenever you like. You can also click the three dots next to it and then change the speed, going from a really slow colour cycle through to an ultra-fast cycle of colours, which is more like a disco effect. And that's pretty neat, especially because there are so many built-in Hue scenes that you can now get pretty much more choice than you had with Hue Labs. Of course, you still can't trigger a custom scene like Winter Beauty on Very Fast from your Hue accessories, which is worth bearing in mind. This won't work. So that's all pretty cool, actually. And if you mainly use the Hue Labs for simple colour cycles, then the new Hue app functionality will probably work out better for you in some cases. It's certainly smoother and less buggy than Hue Labs was, to be honest, because sometimes Hue Lab formulas wouldn't actually start off properly. Or they would start off, but then they'd never actually stop. You'd keep clicking the stop button loads of times, but they'd ignore you and your lights would just keep running, which was annoying. You'd then have to physically power off your light, which obviously wasn't ideal. Hue accessories also had some increased functionality too. The dimmer switch, for example, now has more time-based slots on the app, so you can really customize how your remote will change the lighting of your room based on the individual times of days. You've now got 10 slots, which is really good. And this aims to replace the previous 3 times a charm lamp formula and other similar ones. Hue also has added smart on and off toggle functionality that allows you to actually turn your lights off instead of just constantly cycling through all the colors that you've specified, which I guess is to replace the tap toggle functionality from the Hue apps. One of the other popular lab formulas was for the Hue motion sensor, and it was called No Motion, No Fuss. This was designed to put your lights back into the previous state if no motion was detected for a certain amount of time. This was much better than the default functionality that simply turned your lights off after a certain time. After all, you might have had your lights on a nice dimmed warm white at nighttime, for example, then somebody walked into the room and the lights would have come on really bright. Then eventually, the lights would just go off completely, which was rubbish. This was where the lamp formula came in, but luckily you can now restore this functionality within the Hue app by heading into Settings, then Accessories. Select your motion sensor and then click your desired behavior. Instead of choosing a scene or color, you can select last on state, and this will basically replace the no motion, no fuss behavior. Nice. That wraps up the main types of changes you'll need to make when converting from Hue Labs over to the main app. But there's one thing I haven't covered yet, the natural light feature or scene. One of the benefits of actually smart lighting is being able to change the color temperature to match the time of day. This is explained best by showing the Kelvin scale here. But basically, you know how sunlight is fairly bluey light in the daytime? Well, that's called cool white. Then when it gets later on and the sun starts to set, the light starts turning more yellowy, and that's known as warm white. It would feel weird to sit down and watch TV at night and have bright white light shining in your face, for example. So smart lights prevent this by allowing you to select the color of the light for different times of day, which is nice. The only downside of Philips Hue's previous implementation was that it was always a little bit clunky, until now. Hue have now added a natural light scene under the scenes gallery, and this automatically sets your lights and changes them throughout the day to the right color temperature based on the time of day. This feels a lot more natural and it won't keep you awake at night, which is good. This replaces the time-based lights feature from the Hue Labs. You can also achieve this effect better with your Hue accessories, for example, by adding up to 10 time-based settings for your lights, which I covered previously, because previously things were limited a lot more, you only had more limited time slots. So overall, I'm actually pretty happy with how Philips Hue have been improving the main Hue app. I've long criticized Hue for the clunky Jekyll and Hyde app, where half the features live in the slightly buggy Hue Labs area. So that's good, but there are still some issues, not being able to change the speed of the prism, fireplace, and candle effects, for example. Plus, Hue have reduced the amount of configuration options available to you for quite a few of the lab formulas, often taking fairly complex formulas and basically saying, click this single button in the Hue app to play this new effect. So clearly, some of this new functionality is actually worse than before. Finally, Philips Hue don't really have effective replacements for Sensor Couple, Personal Go to Sleep, and a couple of the other Hue Lab formulas, as you can see on this chart. And that's a pity for sure. Philips Hue are closing down Hue Labs in June 2024. So if you're watching this video before then, I would definitely suggest you actually go into the Hue app and you start clicking around and just seeing whether you like the replacement features or not. If you don't, you have three main options open to you. Firstly, you could explore rival smart lighting providers, but in my experience, the Hue ecosystem does have a lot more power and functionality than many Wi-Fi smart lighting providers. Secondly, you could try exploring a third-party app. There are quite a few, although iConnect Hue and Hue Essentials are probably the most popular replacements. Finally, if you have slightly more complicated lighting automation requirements, including things like coupling your motion sensors together, then a smart home management system like Home Assistant or Hubitat might be a good option for you, because these allow you to configure your smart home behavior in a fairly powerful way. And that wraps up this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please click the thumbs up button. Please also subscribe to this channel to see more videos like this, and thanks for watching.